Welcome back to our channel. Today we will be exploring Mondo, a powerful security and compliance tool that delivers deep insights into your systems and assets. So, what exactly is Mondo? Mondo is a comprehensive security tool that helps you secure your cloud, servers, containers, Kubernetes clusters, images, applications, whatever assets you might have in your IT landscape. It can continuously monitor and assess your assets for vulnerabilities, misconfigurations, and even compliance issues. Think about ISO 27001 or NIS2. All of that is possible with Mondo. Let's take a quick look at the Mondo website. We can already see a screenshot here of the stunning dashboard, which we will explore a little bit later, and all the other things that are important to Mondo, you know, integrating with a lot of different platforms, AWS, Kubernetes, Docker, so on and so forth. Ranking vulnerabilities, also something that we will be looking at later today. You can see it's supporting a wide variety of compliance frameworks. Here again is ISO 27001 and many others as well. And all of this is awesome, easy to implement. This is exactly what I will be showing you today. Additionally, what drives Mondo, all the technology behind it, is actually open source. There are two different tools that Mondo is providing. One of them is called CNCurie, which helps gather information about your assets. You can see here in the short animation down here, so this can scan any asset you have and deliver information about that asset. The second tool is called CNSpec, which helps you define and apply policies or rules, if you want to, for your assets. So it takes the information that CNCurie provides, looks over that information, and then evaluates if a certain asset, you know, is compliant to your rules or not. These rules are called policies in Mondo. We'll start by setting up Mondo on a local client so we can use it. Just, you know, open up any of the two open source tools here and head over to the Get Started area. It will tell you exactly how you can install both tools on your operating system of choice. I'm using macOS here, so this is what I would typically run, but like every good cooking show, I've already prepared that, of course, right? So heading over to my terminal, I can show you that I've already installed CNSpec and I've already installed CNCurie here. If I simply run CNSpec scan local, I can scan my local machine. You will see a progress bar here progressing and I get this nice report here on the command line. Each entry here represents a policy that is either passing or failing. You can see the passing ones are green, the failing ones are red, and so on and so forth. In this case, for example, the ensure macOS is up to date policy is failing. So it seems I haven't updated my macOS to the latest version yet. I also get a final score. I'm currently scoring 45 out of 100 points. So there surely is work to be done on my MacBook. However, some of the policies might not have enough permissions to run on my machine, so it might be an interesting idea to run this with sudo permissions to see if anything changes. Let's do that. I need to enter my sudo password and it's running again. Let's see if the results are changing. No, score is still 45, but it seems that some of the other policies have been fixed by that because it's now having permissions to look into specific files it might not have been allowed to look in earlier. So we will remediate some of those later. By the way, remediation is the process of fixing the issues that policies have found. Fixing security issues is called remediation. If at any point the included policies are not enough for you, you can also create your own custom policies for CNSpec. However, I will not cover that process in this video. Future video on that will be coming, I promise. And again, all the data that these policies are evaluated against is collected by that other tool, by CNQuery, right? You can also run CNQuery directly here on the command line. Let's just do that very quickly. So CNQuery helps me query things on my local machine as well. If I want to, let's get all the services that I'm currently running. I think I need to type that like that. We might have a typo here somewhere. Let's see. So this should list all the services that are currently running on my local machine. Let's see if I made a typo. No, looking good. So you can see there are tons of services running on that MacBook. Way too much for me to evaluate myself manually. So having a policy to do that is a good idea. So both tools work hand in hand. CNQuery gets the information to CNSpec, and CNSpec evaluates these results against the included policies. What else can we do on the local command line except scanning my own local machine? I can also use CNSpec. Let's just clear that very quickly. I can also use CNSpec to scan, for example, Docker images. Let's do the Ubuntu 22.4. I should have pulled that on my machine. So not scanning my machine now, scanning the actual Docker image. And let's see how long this takes. And here we are. The reporting here on the command line is nice. I didn't have to sign up for any Mondoo account or anything to get this working. However, sometimes it would be great to have a more detailed overview of this report. Also, having those reports collected in one place. And the answer to that is the Mondoo console. So if you sign up for a Mondoo account, there is a free community plan which allows you to get started with Mondoo and explore its advanced capabilities. I think it's limited to 50 assets at the same time, and I think one user, I will fact check that if I'm wrong, if anything is different, I will show this here now. Let's head over to the integration section here, right, where we can see all the possible platforms that we can integrate Mondoo with. AWS account is possible, integrating with a local workstation, integrating with Kubernetes, Red Hat, Windows, different cloud security platforms, supply chain tools, and so on and so forth. There's a ton available here, way more that we have time for in this video. I'm looking for macOS here, so I'm gonna use that integration. As you can see, this is generating a token, an authentication token, that the client can use to authenticate towards Mondoo. All that's needed to be installed on the machine that wants to communicate with the dashboard is those CNSpec, CNQuery tools that we saw earlier. Usually you get an all-in-one installation script here. So this is setting the key up here as a Mondoo registration token on the target machine, and then it will install all the tools and set up a configuration file as well. Even though I've already have the tools installed, I'm just doing all of that as well. Let me just clear up the terminal window. I'm putting in the whole shebang from the dashboard and I'm running that. So you can see process is running, configuration is happening. This might take a couple of seconds. All right, process is done. As you can see, it has also set up a service running on my machine now, so it can continuously scan that machine. And with that, you know, authentication is set up. My client can authenticate against the dashboard. So if I run CNSpec scan local again, can now see that this is using a config file that was created by the installation script. And once it's done, it will upload those results to the dashboard. Another thing that has changed is you might notice that we have more policies now that are being checked here. This is because a lot of these policies are included in the Mondoo account, right? So some of them you only have access to with the account. For example, here's a very interesting one here at the end. It's checking which version of Firefox I've installed. That's the browser of my choice. As you can see, I'm using this version. There is a newer one already released, so I should update my Firefox as well. Finally, I get the link here at the bottom, which I can follow to see the report in the dashboard. And as you can see, I have a representation of the local command line result now here in the dashboard. macOS security, 28 policies are passing, 5 are failing. Some extra information about my machine here, operating system, memory, and so on. If I click on that, I can evaluate each policy again. As you can see, I'm still on the older version of macOS here on purpose, of course. So we have a policy here to fail. I can open up that policy. I can see what query command is being used to check for that policy. I can see the result that CNSpec has produced, right, by checking the policy, and I get a description of the policy and also a remediation step. And this is something I absolutely love about Mondoo. Once you have that community plan, that dashboard, it's not only telling you what's good and what's bad, but it also gives you hints on how to fix it. If I move over to the software tab here, you can see the Firefox policy failing, right? So it's not in the newest version yet, but this is something that we can remediate very quickly. With that, the Firefox should be updated. If I'm looking at the version, yes, it's now 129.0. That should be the newest one. I can run the scan again. Let's see if we fix the Firefox vulnerability here. And yes, the Firefox vulnerability here has gone. By the way, I'm not entirely sure why the command line output here is showing me a different score, right? Maybe it's a bug in that current version of CNSpec. I think the dashboard is correct with 46%. Earlier, I had 45% with the open source command line scanning. Maybe this is just rounded up to 46, but I'm not sure where the 91 here are coming from. I guess there is something going on here. It's not a big deal, as long as I know, you know, what is failing and what is succeeding. Just wanted to point that out in case anybody is confused. Let's do one more integration with Mondoo. Let's integrate an AWS account into that Mondoo dashboard. I'm already here at the integrations page. And if you want to integrate an AWS account, all you need to do is to click the AWS integration here. And then you have two options. You can use Mondoo Hosted, which is the easiest way to get started, I would say. This will use AWS credentials that you provide to Mondoo to scan assets inside your AWS account. Now, that might be a problem for some of you, you know, for some organizations, for banks, especially giving credentials to another platform is always a bit tricky, right? So make sure this aligns with your company guidelines. The other option, which is called serverless. This means that Mondoo will give you a CloudFormation template, basically an infrastructure creation script that you can run inside of AWS and deploy it in there. This will set up a serverless function that will scan your assets and send results to Mondoo, right? So from inside of AWS to your Mondoo account. This way, you don't have to give it any credentials, right? You don't need to give any credentials to Mondoo. Everything is happening in a push manner of speaking, right? So AWS is pushing information into Mondoo with the Mondoo hosted option. Mondoo is pulling the information from AWS. Let's integrate one of those. Just for simplicity's sake, I'm gonna go with Mondoo hosted. If I select that, I can give my integration an interesting name. And I need to supply it with an access key ID and AWS secret access key, so the API credentials that a specific user have. If you're going that route, I would highly recommend that you're creating a separate Mondoo user. Don't use your personal ones and only give that Mondoo user the permissions on AWS that it needs to read information from an infrastructure. Don't give it power user or administrator access, please. So fast forward, I've already done that AWS integration. Takes a bit of time until everything is scanned. And you can see additionally to my one MacBook here, Darwin is the word for the macOS operating system. We get about 160 assets now from an AWS account that I've added. I've added our account that is hosting the company websites just to have something to show you. If I select my AWS inventory now, you can see operating system here. That's my MacBook from earlier. And AWS is in here. That account, as you can see, gets a score of F. The reason is we have a ton of public S3 buckets in there, right? If you want to put a website in there that the public internet wants to access, then obviously you have to make them public so people can access them. If we open one of them, we can see looking at the policies, AWS security policies, let's check which ones are failing. As you can see, it's very great to analyze everything in here, very easy to find our checks. You can see that verify bucket level public access restrictions for Amazon S3 buckets is failing, right? So from a security standpoint, of course, having a public S3 bucket is not a good idea, except if you want to host a public website in there. I could turn this off, right, for these buckets, so it's not scanning those and we have a better score. But other than that, you know, we get a great overview of everything that's running in there. I can see my VPCs. It's checking on security groups in there. You know, a lot of public ones in here as well because of the websites. You can check how good user passwords are. I'm not showing you the usernames here, right? But it seems we have some work to do in this account and so on and so forth, right? So for every service that's on AWS, there is a set of policies that Mondoo can use for scanning. It gives you a great overview on that. And that's my quick overview of Mondoo, a powerful tool to enhance security and compliance across all your environments. You know, with its comprehensive scanning capabilities, easy integration, detailed reports, a free community plan, right? And even remediation advice, custom policies, everything you want from a security tool is there. I love it a lot, right? So give it a try. For more details and to get started with Mondoo, head over to their website, mondoo.com. Thank you for watching. If this video was helpful to you, you know, make sure to check out our website, infralovers.com, and explore our courses and services. Feel free to leave any questions in the comments below. If you want to see more videos about Mondoo, let me also know in the comments. I see you in the next video. I will go now and update my macOS. I wish you a nice rest of the day. See you in the next one. Goodbye.